So if you believe in freedom of speech and the Constitution and the Bill of Rights, you are a fascist, you are a bigot, you are a Nazi, you are a racist, sexist, homophobe. If you believe in any of that, you're an evil piece of crap. So, all right, so let's move into the dehumanization stage, right? Dehumanization is the denial of the humanity of a group. Group here equals conservatives, classical liberals, the internet, or you know, the internet dark web or intellectual dark web, the IDW, the constitutionalists, the patriotic Americans. Here's the group now that I want you to keep in mind. This group, we've been talking about it, but this group here is where the far left and the mainstream media now has been dehumanizing, right? It's this group right here. Individuals from a group are identified as subhuman or non-humans. They are often referred to as animals, vermin, insects, or diseases. They're referred to as bigots, homophobes, racists, sexists, xenophobes, hateful, intolerant, deplorables, white supremacists, neo-Nazis, fascists, ignorant, privileged males, or just privileged, so on and so forth. These are the buzzwords that are thrown around at the group of anybody who's a patriot or a classical liberal or a conservative or is on or the, you know, the Joe Rogans of the world to the Dave Rubens of the world to the Jordan Petersons to the Ben Shapiros to these internet intellectual dark web people that are actually challenging the thought that censoring and the takedown of free speech and free exchange of ideas is a terrible idea. These are the people that are completely and totally, Ben Shapiro, for crying out loud, has been called a racist. Ben Shapiro, right? He's a Nazi. Ben Shapiro, the devout Jewish man, right? Yeah, it does defy logic. It doesn't kind of defy logic. It thoroughly defies logic. As a result of the dehumanization, It says, the process of dehumanization portrays group members as innately threatening to society. Tell me that isn't what's being said by the mainstream right now and by those who are attacking the right. Tell me that doesn't apply. Please, tell me that doesn't apply. That from all the Democratic presidential candidates to all the mainstream media on the left to all of the social media giants, Silicon Valleys, tell me that doesn't apply with a straight face. Try not to crack a smile when you say that. That the process of dehumanization portrays group members as innately threatening to society, meaning that they are threatening solely because they are members of the group. As a result of dehumanization, crimes and attacks against members of the group are allowed to occur with impunity. They are ignored by authorities such as the police and the courts. Smear campaigns, deplatforming, unpersoning, demonetization, censoring, ridiculing, silencing, and actual battery and assault. Right? All these things are happening. You think of the Cuffington kids, right? You think of what happened there where they just got smeared before any of the facts were out because it was a bunch of white little smirky kids wearing a Make America Great hat. Then all of a sudden all the background comes out and all the news comes out and all the actual facts come out on it. And they actually were the ones that were not doing anything. They were the ones who were approached. They were the ones who were getting assailed and assaulted by the black Israelites. They were the ones that were getting, people were going at them. Everything gets twisted. The Jussie Smollett, all of a sudden, Jussie Smollett, right? It's MAGA hat country, bitch. And he gets attacked, right? And everyone's screaming at how it's all this, it's Trump's fault and it's white American and so on and so forth. And we find out, oh, wait, it was all a freaking lie. Right? This goes on and on. There was the other kid, the other gay trans person that said that Trump supporters or Republicans, conservatives burnt his house down, right? Well, it turns out he burned his own house down. So you got the fake crimes, you got these fake hate crimes, and there's a bunch of fake hate crimes that have happened that don't get reported on, a bunch of them that get pointed at the conservatives. There is a absolute and undeniable assault against people, against conservatives and the right to absolutely dehumanize them. They are not people. Examples of events that would be tagged as dehumanization include authoritative sources such as government officials or media personalities deny the humanity of group members. Group members are portrayed as non-human or subhuman. Again, deplorables and so on and so forth. representation of the group as an innate threat to society. Individuals are, by extension, considered threats based solely on the group membership. So if you believe in freedom of speech and the Constitution and the Bill of Rights, you are a fascist, you are a bigot, you are a Nazi, you are a racist, sexist, homophobe. If you believe in any of that, you're an evil piece of crap. Crimes and attacks against members of the group are ignored or encouraged. What did Carlos Maza just come out and say? What did he just come out and say? He's the one who cried foul when Steven Crowder was simply taking down his videos, his strike-through videos, right? And making some snarky little schneid remarks about his sexual preference and making fun of him in a comedic way. Whether or not it's funny or you think it's funny or not, that's up to you, and I'm not going to debate that with you right now. But what did he do? He actually was just simply rebutting this guy's video, and this guy gets so butthurt, no pun intended, by this, that he actually goes out and says, started everything he did. I'm not going to rehash the whole thing. Everybody knows about it by this point. But what did Carlos Maza say? Carlos Maza called Tucker Carlson a white supremacist. He's calling Tucker Carlson a white supremacist, and then he says he actually calls for violence. He actually crosses the line of free speech, that all conservatives would agree with is the line, which is call to action. Call to action is where everyone's like, what do we do? I don't understand what we do with free speech, man, because, well, you know, free speech, it's just a slippery slope. So where do we make the terms and conditions, and how do we do it? It's pretty simple. The old farts a couple hundred years back when they figured out the Bill of Rights figured it out. What they said, what it stands for, or where the line is when you call for action to be done against somebody, that's the line. You should be able to say whatever the F you want to say about anybody and everybody and anything. When you call to action, like telling his supporters, his million followers, to throw milkshakes in the face of people they disagree with, when you're Maxine Waters and you're calling for people to harass and assault people that disagree with you on the right, when you call for action, you've crossed the line. That's how simple it needs to be. Why are we making this more difficult than it needs to be? That is the line. Courts refuse to prosecute and police refuse to arrest the perpetrators. MSN attacks, the doxings, the call for violence, the calls for ridicule, examples like I've already given, the Covington boys, Kathy Griffin calling out, cutting off the head of the doll, the MAGA head attacks, the Don Lemon comments, right? Silicon Valley, with everything they've said, from the Jack Dorseys to the Mark Zuckerbergs to the Susan Wojcicki's, whatever her name is, Wojcicki, like off the, Monsters, Inc. When you call for action, that's the point. That's the point where you should have an issue. And as we see right here, courts refuse to prosecute. The public court refuses to prosecute against the takedown of these people. Let's take Tommy Robinson, for instance, and Gavin McGinnis. The SPLC, which turns out the leaders of the SPLC were racist pigs, right? There was a whole big thing. He got fired, and I think there were some sexual misconduct pieces. He was a complete pervert, right? So it's kind of funny, the hypocrisy there. But the SPLC, who is a far, far left-leaning organization, smeared Gavin McGinnis and said that he was a neo-Nazi, white supremacist, and smeared him so bad he got deplatformed off of everything. So much so that Gavin McGinnis is suing the SPLC, and it looks like he's probably going to win, right? As is the Covington boys. They're pushing back on this because nothing was done. Nothing was done against these organizations that are on the left, that are left-leaning, that did this assault against the right. Nothing's done to them. They're just given a free freaking pass. Free pass. Free pretty much pass. Nobody calls them to account. One thing I'm going to shout out for Drone Tech. I got Drone Tech shirt on right here. Right there, Drone Tech. Call out to Drone Tech. Shout out to Drone Tech. I appreciate Drone's video so much because he does a lot of work on those, you guys. And if you're not supporting him, you need to be. You need to be subscribed to him and be on Patreon with that guy because, he puts them out weekly of, like, just calling out the fake BS with CNN. That's kind of his niche, right? The CNN, MSNBC. And he niches on that, and he does it better than almost anybody out there does. And he calls out all the fake things, how nothing happens to you. These people perpetuate lies constantly and nothing happens to them, right? It is absolutely, absolutely happening. And it's been happening for a long time. And now people are starting to rise up and push back and say, this is a bunch of bullshit and we're not going to take it anymore, right? So anyways, I don't know if that was, might have got off track a little bit on that one, but I don't think it did.